Today, I am going to discuss regarding digital communication techniques. First one, define signal and classify them. Signal means it is a function of one or more independent variables which contains some information. Example, information signal, second one, electrical signal. Then, now we are going to see regarding classification of signals. First one, continuous and discrete time signal. Second one, analog and digital signals, even and odd signals, periodic and non-periodic signals, real and complex signals, deterministic and random signals, energy and power signals. First one, continuous and discrete signals. Continuous means it is continuously varying with the time. Discrete means which has got fixed values 1 or 0. Analog, the analog in nature, that is which will be continuously varying with the time. Digital signals which has got specific values, that is 1 or 0. Even and odd functions, that is sine wave or cos wave, like that, these are even and odd signals. Periodic, non-periodic. Then real and complex signals. Real terms, imaginary terms. Deterministic, which has got fixed values. Random signals, which may change their values. Energy and power. Power means which will be determined by the P equal to I square R, like that, in terms of watt. Now, we are going to discuss regarding passband signal, its merits. It can be transmitted over long distance, or long distance can be achieved. Small dimension antennas can be used to radiate the signal. No bigger antennas will be required, very smaller antennas will be required. Then effects of noise and interference can be minimized. There is a no noise and there is a no interference. No external signals will be mixed. The original signal we are going to getting. Then multiplexing technique can be used to create multiple channels. Multiplexing means we are going to getting more signals than getting any one signal at the output. That is, multiplexing is possible. Multiplexing and multiple channels. Next one, any system has got its advantages, disadvantages, or merits and demerits. Similar way, passband systems are more complex and expensive because they requires modems are required for the purpose of frequency translation. Now, we are going to discuss regarding third point, that is information capacity and Shannon's theorem. Information capacity, it is amount of discrete information bits that can be reliably transmitted over a channel, that is raw bits can be transmitted for ones and zeros. The scientist Shannon has given some statements regarding what information capacity, that is Shannon's theorem. It states that for reliable communication, it is possible to provide an information rate R is below a certain threshold called channel capacity, that is C, that is R is less than C. Channel capacity is achieved with the appropriate encoding and decoding systems. Already we have studied in the beginning, encoding and decoding. Then opposite way, conversely, if R is greater than or equal to C, probability of error at receiver increases as information rate R increases and no useful information can be reproduced. Shannon's theorem tells the theoretical maximum information transfer rate of the channel for a particular noise level. Now, we are going to discuss regarding the bit rate, entropy and baud rate. bit rate, it is defined as the rate at which data is transmitted. That is the number of raw bits, ones or one or zeros are transmitted, in what rate we are going to transmitting. It is expressed in bits per second. Bits per second, that simply it is BPS. The common unit of bit rate is kilobits per second, KBPS. Next definition, entropy. It is a measure of average information. The information whatever we are going to transmitting, no, it is called the average information. Content per source symbol, it is denoted by H, and unit bits per message. Next one, definition, baud rate. It is the product of message rate and entropy. It is denoted by R unit bits per second. Comparison of analog communication and digital communication system. Analog communication system, digital communication system. Transmitted modulated signal is analog in nature. Transmitted modulated signal is digital in nature. For analog communication, noise immunity is poor. Noise immunity is excellent in case of digital communication system. In analog communication system, accuracy is less. In a digital communication system, accuracy is more. Cost is more. In case of analog communication system, cost is less. In digital communication system, repeaters cannot be used. In case of analog communication system, repeaters can be used in digital communication system. Repeaters can be used to get the original information. Again, it can be detected and amplified and transmitted. Mass production is easy and cheap in case of analog communication, not easy and cheap in digital communication system. Now we are going to study regarding Shannon and Hartley theorem. It states that the channel capacity and a white band limited Gaussian channel as C equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2 bits per second. C stands for channel capacity, B stands for bandwidth, S for signal power, N equal to total noise. Shannon's Hartley theorem is complementary to Shannon's theorem, and it applies to a noisy channel. As the bandwidth increases, noise power increases. Shannon-Hartley theorem tells the maximum rate at which information can be transmitted over a communication channel of a specified bandwidth in the presence of noise. Then we are going to discuss regarding baseband transmission. In communication system, a signal of primary interest is a message signal delivered by a source of information. Such signal is called baseband signal. Baseband signals can be analog or digital type. When a physical waveform such as sound wave or light wave is converted into electrical signal, then such signal referred to as analog baseband signal. The output of digital computer is an example of a digital baseband signal. Coming to passband transmission, if modulated signal is transmitted over the channel, it is called passband signal transmission. When a message signal is impressed carrier, the modulated signal is generated, so passband frequency band is much greater than the message frequency band. Passband transmission is generally used at high frequencies and for long distances compared to baseband signals. Some important terms we are going to study: amount of information, baud rate. Amount of information, it is a dimensionless quantity. Consider communication system which transmit messages M1, M2, M3. They have the probability of occurrence P1, P2, P3 respectively. The amount of information transmitted through the message MK with the probability PK is given as IK equal to log 1 divided by PK to the base 2 bits. Baud rate, it is the product of message rate and entropy, denoted as R. Unit is bits per second. R equal to small r into h. R equal to baud rate, small r equal to message rate, h equal to entropy. Generation and detection of PAM. Above figure shows generation of PAM. Gate is there. First block, a stable clock, one shot. The figure consists of modulating signal and two polarity PAM. The figure consists of three sections: a stable multivibrator, monostable multivibrator, sampling rate. A stable multivibrator, FS greater than or equal to 2FX. FS sampling rate, FX highest frequency component of analog input signal. Monostable multivibrator, it produces a pulse train of constant pulse width and frequency FS. Sampling gate, when the output of monostable multivibrator is high state, sampling gate is enabled and analog signal at input is allowed to appear at output. Detection of PAM signal is shown below. First, received PAM signal, low pass filter, recovered message signal. Received PAM signal is applied to low pass filter, which removes component at FS and allowed only FX signal. This process is similar to that of AM diode detection. Merits and demerits of PWM. Merits: more accurate than PAM, greater immunity to additive noise compared to PM. Demerits: requires large bandwidth, non-linear modulation. Below figure shows generation of PPM, pulse position modulation. Merits of PPM: more accurate than PAM, greater immunity to additive noise compared to PAM use less power than PWM. Demerits, demodulation power is more difficult.